like if you take this example, maybe like looks like infinity component, but we have printed and it's jointless. It has been printed all assembled, so you can see all moving parts are there.
One of the biggest application, whether it's plastic or metal, is aerospace. It could be in the form of drones, unidentified aerial vehicles, the connectors, impeller. So, in especially in space application, weight reduction is the main concern. So, anything which reduces a small pounds of weight can be lead to great fuel savings. So, in the lower part, you can see there's a plate. It is all 3D printed. Pilotless plate is 4 meter in length and only 21 kgs. So this was being tested in 2018 by Thor. The name is Thor, but Airbus was the company which designed and printed this plane. So day by day application of plastic printing is also coming up, especially with this weight reduction, BS6 implantation. So every field is like automatic, it is also getting application.
So it was the first engine which was flown using a 3D printed part. So typically this nozzle was there, but this is a typical shape. But with weight optimization and with 3D we can join multiple parts. So aisa, and whenever you are using the mechanical joint, so we are improving the efficiency, the functionality.
But with that kind of softwares, topology of the end topology is there, Tosca is there, the ANSYS is there, solid Altair solid thinking is there. There are many software available. आप उसे यूज करके उसमें कंस्ट्रेंट लगा दीजिए, यहाँ से मुझे मेटेरियल रिमूव नहीं, इसमें फंक्शनलिटी हम करना, वहाँ से जैसे मुझे मेटेरियल की जरूरत नहीं वहाँ से रिमूव कर दें. तो टिपिकल यूजिंग ऑल दो सॉफ्टवेयर सेम अर्लियर 55 ग्राम एल्यूमिनियम इट मे हैव रिड्यूस्ड टू 120 ग्राम बट विद AN इट गो टू रिड्यूस टू 68 ग्राम. सो बट ये भी थिंक लॉन्गर पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, ठीक है मेरा एक प्लेन लेता हूँ, इट कीप्स अ थ्रू 20 इयर्स, इट विल सेव लॉट ऑफ फ्यूल. सो ऑल दैट लाइक यू हैव टू सेलेक्ट द इंडस्ट्री राइट कंपोनेंट फॉर दैट.
इन ऑटोमोटिव्स सो दे आर यूजिंग सम हाउ दे आर यूजिंग दिस टेक्नोलॉजी फॉर देयर डे टू डे एक्टिविटीज बिकॉज दे आर नॉट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग मास एंड नाउ दे आर अपिंग मच ऑफ कस्टमाइजेशन पार्ट. सो विद कस्टमाइजेशन 3D printing becomes more useful. Otherwise, you have to design dies or individual components that becomes very expensive. But with 3D printing, usually like parts can be printed. So applications could be in the form of like window levers, in assemblies, then motor covers, even full dashboards and keys, and in the last picture, you can say, oh, a 3D printed cars. So nowadays you can design whole vehicle with 3D printing. So, but a typical polymer won't have that much strength. So, what are the metal being used is with some kind of fiber reinforced, maybe carbon or glass fiber reinforced depending on application. So, some reinforcement is done to like get a functional parts for this kind of applications.
Then similar one, agar main automotive ki baat karun, to ek casing hai automatic full housing ki. जो एल्यूमिनियम प्रेशर डाई कास्टिंग जो बनती है, तो टिपिकली 2 kg मुझे वेट लगता है, एल्यूमिनियम लगेगा मुझे इसको बनाने का. मैंशली वेस्टेज आधी हो जाएगी मेरी 1.808 ग्राम्स और मेटेरियल अफेंशन में 46%. लेकिन वहीं पे मैं लास्ट वाले पे AM पे करूँ तो मुझे 316L में बात करता हूँ मैं तो 0.89 ग्राम लगता है, क्योंकि मेरी वेस्टेज बहुत कम होगी. ओनली वेस्टेज इन द फॉर्म सपोर्ट स्ट्रक्चर. So all those things depending upon whatever you want to do, and but it increases the cost. Recently we were discussing with Hero Motors R&D manager, so we met in a conference. So wo kehta hai ki agar main AM use karta hu to meri cost bachati hai. Today AM is costly. To aur jo customer hai usko agar TVS Hero Honda ki bike agar 1000 rupaye mehngi ho gayi to he will move to TVS one. Hai तो वो मार्केट सेंसिटिव, बहुत कॉस्ट सेंसिटिव है. तो आप किस मार्केट सेगमेंट में हैं वो भी डिसाइड करना पड़ेगा, है ना. फिर से इफ वी स्टार्ट बिल्डिंग एनी कन्वर्शन कंपोनेंट AM, इट इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी एक्सपेंसिव. सो ओनली कंपोनेंट लाइक बट ऑडी इन मारुति 800 AM प्रिंटेड कम राइट नाउ मे नॉट बी कॉस्ट वायबल इनविजिबल, बट ऑडी इन विच द कस्टमर्स नॉट दैट मीन कॉस्ट कॉन्शियस, सो दे आर ऑल यू स्टार्टेड यूजिंग दिस. So improving the performance. So cost or अगर इस market segment में वो बहुत ध्यान रखना पड़ता है.
So this is a Renault truck
video. It was weighing 525 gram, 841 parts. So again, using topology optimization, how this weight can be reduced and how this AM can be used in this. The different parts we can use. Kar sakte hain. So again, we use software to provide the constraints. Another method remove ho sakta hai. So even 500 grams per part, agar assembly mein baat kare, in a whole assembly, a lot of saving is there. I call it engine block. So 545 parts are 200 parts and weight around 120 kg produced ho gaya. This price is using 3D printing, but the cost is the main concern. Wo aapko dekhna padega. Ab now we come to tooling part. There is another great application. Tooling mein normally aap kya lete hain? You take a block, different operations karenge, milling, turning, drilling wagera. Uske baad after long time, which is complex, you get a print die. अगर आपके पास प्रिंटर है सो द स्टेप इज कैड फॉइल टू मैट मशीन देन यू गेट अ डाई इंसर्ट. सो आपका जो टाइम जो है यू मे थिंक कि ठीक है मेरा कॉस्टली बहुत ज़्यादा है बट इन टर्म्स ऑफ टाइम व्हाट यू सेव आर टिपिकली डाई इंसर्ट टेकिंग वन मंथ फॉर लाइक मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इट मे बी रेडी फॉर यू इन थ्री और फोर डेज. सो 20-25 डेज सेविंग एंड दैट टू man are saving other electricity process if you need to. So it is going to prove a cheaper one than the conventional one. Then conformer coolings. If you are like the pure molding high temperature polymers, so dye becomes heat up. Also variety wagera bar jata hai. So but with 3D printing you can put internal channels for cooling in which you can use the coolant for cooling this. So typically this is the one. And if we design with conformer coolings, we can all design this cooling channel at the top of the part also. And this shows the temperature like the morpho analysis. So it is a conventional part. This, all this part was heated up. With this printed part with this conformer cooling, it is all cool one. So not much temperature difference.
What it is called?
Sorry?
What it is?
Temperature which has been during molding condition. So without conformer cooling, without internal cooling channels, so this is a temperature difference. So it is very high temperature but this one. Here it is almost similar one, almost 5 degree difference was there. So your dye life will increase. So another application, repair. You already have one dye insert mold and it's worn out. So this 3D printing can be used for repair application. So you can see here it is all broken one. The closer one part, here it is broken one. So what we will do is, if you have 3D model of that, then it's good one. If you don't, you have to re-scan it. Do the reverse engineering to get the CAD model of it. Then shave off the part, the broken part. Align that part into your machine. Build, deposit powder over that, and you get a repaired part for that. But you can do it powder bed position. You choose powder bed. Use the reporter one. But this deposition bed techniques are much more simpler and much convenient for this kind of applications. So both can be used, but it was simplicity one, so it will simply deposit one, so it becomes easy. Here the referencing becomes a main concern. So this is some of my initial work in 2004. So at that time we had one project from DRDO for induction molding of peak which is high temperature column that too with carbon fiber reinforced. So we, at that time, this metal machine was only available in CMTI Bangalore, and initially they had only this bronze composition available with them, powder available with them. So we did design those molds and used their facility for printing 2004. Then the machine upgraded for steel, and with bronze mold, as I was talking about earlier lecture, so all these features were there. The peak is so, the carbon fiber involved was so strong that while injection, it took all these features with the peak component. So it was so soft, and with steel mold, the strength was pretty good. So just this is an example of like topology optimization. This is an antenna for the aerospace. With topology optimization, you get this kind of shape, and then you can print it. So, but you have to use the correct software. Now I come to my domain. This is medical. So typically, if we talk about implants from manufacturing point of view, I can divide into two categories: standard implant, trauma plate, hip, knee, spine one, which the doctor, the required doctor is special size and the type. It's available in the market and mass produced. The other ones are patient specific, sometimes due to trauma or disease, the site is something like that, in which they're not conventionally available in the market, it is just particular for one patient. So we have to both these domains. So, okay, a person has got arthritis or trauma, he has got his joint replaced. But typically all these hip or knee, if you remember when the medicine is okay, we have implant which lasts 20-30 years. So means if a person living more than that, he has to go for revision surgeries. So implant is replaced. But 20-30 years in like... Now if we come to industry, we have many grippers, pick and place robots, and special school robotics for teaching purpose. Many parts are being printed for the industrial application, which could be directly employed in factories. So this is our machine, this is a metal printer, and it's some components which are 3D printed in plastic. This is a laminar flow component which is inside the machine which controls the gas flow. So a 3D print, a metal printer machine is having a plastic 3D printed part in itself. So like there are some, one of the major, many connectors are there which are 3D printed. So like in metal printer also you can 3D print it. Now, when we talk day-to-day life, like in foreign countries, many parts.
Sir, I asked a question to one of the experts, when we print these nozzles, etc., so we require very, very high, you know, level of surface finish inside the nozzle. How do we achieve that surface finish? Because in case of 3D printing, we cannot have that much of surface.
Actually, there are two things. There are two ways we control it. One is like with parameter optimization. The parameter we like get up to around 8 to 10 microns if we under the metal only. So typically we get 30-40 microns if we don't optimize that with certain parameters. But to optimize for like the surface finish, we can go up to 8 to 10 microns, something like that. But your build time will increase and parameter strength. Otherwise, if nozzle kind of thing, then there are finishing processes which is liquid media.
Yeah.
So you have to go for that, like MRF is there, nanoresorbable fluids are there, and some other techniques like which is very fine particles, with abrasive particles, microns, and they're pushing with high pressure, so they erode it and you get a fine finish kind of thing. So there is a company in Baddi, Phoenix, I think Phoenix is the name, I'm not very sure about it. So they have some proprietary process. So any 3D printed part you give, they will give you mirror finish. So process are available, but you have to select, decide what, how much accuracy is required. So any application for which you don't require mirror finish, but unless it's spending or it doesn't make any difference. So like medical implant, metal implants. So typically, if it's not a bearing surface, which means two parts are not mating and don't require any fine finish, so there is no point in going for like very high mirror finish. But if it's a mating surface, like hip or knee joint in which two parts are mating, so I will require a mirror finish. So it reduces my the inner component wear rate. So it depends on your application, but processor available, you should get finished inner surface also. So for plastic printing in day-to-day lifestyle, so mobile covers.
So this sometimes my own students do, like they learn and they make a functional part, a useful part. So if you have a plastic printer in at your home, etc., instead of buying your standard one, you can own design own fancy mobile covers with all kind of the structures. So normally you won't find this kind of structured mobile cover, anything like that in market. So this, you have softwares available, you use those software, print it and have your customized one. So then suppose if you want to print, okay, I have a bag, one my buckle is broken one. So instead of like buying, if I don't get in market, instead of going for a new bag, I can simply print a buckle and use it. This we are using in our day-to-day life, like some machine parts are broken, so we are printing our machine, plastic printer, and we use it for like purpose. Then some sports equipment, helmets. Special for these helmets, we use normally a thermocol cover layer is there. So instead of thermocol, if we design plastic one with lattice structures, mm-hmm. with beams, so it becomes greater impact resistance. So this way it is being used. Then musical instruments. So nowadays musical instruments, different materials are can be printed using plastic printing. Then all those ones, remote control, which all these things can be. Now shoes. So soles, full shoes. In fact, Adidas has used the plastic waste from oceans and converted to filaments and used those for printing their shoes. So in a way, it is all, though it is waste, very less waste in printing, but even from waste materials, we are like from waste to wealth. So Adidas is making their shoes with that. Then elbows, prosthesis, then say dress. So any process, if you can design without support structure, like SLS is the one in which we don't use any support structures, so we can even print dresses for that, it's customized. So, but if you talk about SLS support free, but typically we get only white or black parts. So then, but if you dye them correctly with the correct chemicals, so you can make their own fancy parts. So like typically with SLS, it's only white. So if you say dark part, it was only white, so typically if it's your DPU, then it's going to grey or blackish, or it's white. So you have to dye them for like other functional components. But if it's multi-jet fusion, which HP is employed, which can be multi-material, then straight away you can put a colored different, like combination of different colors you can make. Then architecture. So typically whenever some, even if like you enter, I don't know there, but when I was in back during my graduation, so there in between there was a whole model was there of PC building. So those two used to make by hand, but now you can make a CAD model printed in different metal, transparent one using SLA or any transparent filament. But nowadays even buildings are being printed using cement building. China has built multi-story buildings using FDM cement concrete mixer using FDM kind of printer. So basic technique remains the same. You have nozzle, you mix a concrete, fill it and deposit as nozzle. So this is another application for this. This is something that we discussed on my earlier lecture, pattern for investment casting. So I'll just repeat it. So for aluminium cylinder head of the bike.
So thank you. So this is something which we are doing in all these two.